video, we will learn about how to interface a 4x3 matrix keypad to the 8051 microcontroller. This 4x3 matrix keypad is very popular. You might have seen it in your phone. So it will be having keys 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, star, 0, hash. So this 4x3 matrix keypad, we are going to interface to our microcontroller 8051. So as the name only tells 4x3, it indicates 4 rows and 3 columns. There is one more keypad available in the market, which is 4x4 also. So here we are learning about only 4x3, same is applicable to 4x4 as well. So as it is 4x3 matrix keypad, having 4 rows and 3 columns, so it indicates clearly that there are 7 pins. So 7 pins of this device, we are going to interface to the 7 pins of our 8051 microcontroller. So in this interfacing part, I have selected port 1. I used port 1 to connect to the complete pins of our 4x3 matrix keypad. So this 4x3 matrix keypad is having 4 rows. This is row 0 and row 1, row 2 and row 3. You can give any name, R1, R2, R3 and R4 also. So I used R0, R1, R2, R3. There are 4 rows and we have 4 columns. C1, so we will start with C0, C0, C1 and C2. So these are the 3 columns and these are the 4 columns available. And I have connected this row 0 to P1.0, row 1 to P1.1 and row 2 to P1.2 and row 3 to P1.3. So rows are connected to first 4 pins of the microcontroller. P1.0, 1.1, 1.2 and 1.3. And columns are connected to, this is column 0. Column 0 is connected to P1.4. Column 1 is connected to P1.5 and column 2 is connected to P1.6. So this is the interfacing of 4x3 matrix keypad. We have connected 4 rows and 3 columns to the microcontroller. So here what I am going to do is, after interfacing this device to the microcontroller, in order to get acknowledgement of reading a particular key, what it is, I have connected 8 LEDs to the microcontroller also. So whenever I press particular key, I would like to display something onto this output devices. This is an input device, so I have selected output device LED. Even you can select LCD also. So whatever you type in the keypad, that should come in the LCD. Or whatever the key you press in the keypad, accordingly you should get some display in the LEDs. So what I am going to do here is, if I press key number 1, I will get the LED number 1. LED 1 will glow. If I press key 2, LED 2 will glow, which is connected to P2.1. Similarly, so on up to 8 LEDs are there. So if I press 8th button, 8 LED will glow. And 9th button, if I press, I have choose some other pattern, blinking of these LEDs. Similarly, star, 0 and hash. So this programming part, again, we will discuss in the software part. There we can see how to program this device, 8051, to interface the keypad 4x3. And then we will also see the simulation part of it in the routines. And what logic we are implementing here is, we are pulling all the 4 rows. These are the 4 rows. We are pulling all the 4 rows to logic high. I have connected these 4 rows to VCC terminal. And then I have connected 3 columns to ground. So this can be done in the program simply by using a code P1 is equal to 0xF0. If I write this in the programming part, P1 is equal to 0xF0. So I am giving all 1s in the first 4 and then I am giving zeros in the next 3. Even you can see, you can do it in reverse also. Here I think I made F0 instead of 0F. F0 instead of F0, I made 0F. No, it's F0 only, correct. It is F0. So, first 4 bits of the microcontroller are connected to 0 and the next 4 bits are connected to 1s. So, higher bits are connected to 1 and lower bits are connected to 0. So it's direct. I made it 0F only, not 0. Right? So otherwise you can do it in reverse also. F0 is also positive. Either you have to pull the rows to the ground or you have to pull the columns to the ground. Then what we have to do is, we will again make this particular R0 to 0. I will write R0 is equal to 0. I will write here. I will write R0 is equal to 0. And then I will scan for column 0, column 1 and column 2. Whether this column 1 is pressed, column 2 is pressed or column 3 is pressed. This is called key scan. We will make a particular row to 0 and then we will scan the 3 columns. So if I make this R0 is equal to 0, then I am checking here whether this key is pressed or this key is pressed or this key is pressed. So how we will get such information is, so whenever this key is pressed, you can observe here the key arrangement. Whenever this key is pressed, it will contact this will come in contact with these two terminals. Then this column and this row will get short. So voltage will flow from this R0 to column 0, or in reverse, column 0 to R0, according to the configuration we made, either F0 or 0F. So because of that voltage flowing from row to column, microcontroller will sense that this key is pressed. Else we will go to the second one. If this key is pressed or not, or if this key is pressed or not. If all the three keys are not pressed, then we will go to the second one. We will make R1 equal to 0 and then we will again scan for column 0, column 1 and column 2. If any key is pressed, it will sense that voltage flow from the respective column to ground or from the respective column to row or from row to column. Else we will scan the next row or next row like that. So this we will see in the programming part in here. So in this way we can sense a particular key press, and according to the key press we will write a code. If this key is pressed, switch on this LED. If this key is pressed, switch on this LED. So that also we will see in the programming part. So this is a very simple interfacing to the microcontroller 8051. 7 terminals of the 4x3 matrix keypad are connected to the 7 pins of port P1. That is simple interfacing of 4x3 matrix keypad to the 8051. And you have to make sure that these rows are connected to VCC and columns are connected to ground or vice versa. You can choose any logic while designing the circuit. So that is about the 4x3 matrix keypad interface to 8051. And in the simulation part, we will see how to get output by for every key press. Thank you for watching.